I'm so happy that I get to do your hair today, so thank you so much. I promise I will not screw this up. I know it's bleaching, so please know that it is permanent. I'm so happy I get to do this. Thank you, thank you. It is my first time. I've had people do it on me, so I kind of know what I'm doing. Sort of. You know? Once again, thank you so much for letting me do this. I've been waiting way too long. Way too long. Now let's get started. First off, okay, I don't have the really nice gloves because we're running low on some things. So we got the crappy plastic gloves. They don't have the same like the like sharp twang. Not twang, like snap to it. Right. Have you colored your hair before? Or dyed it? Okay, that's good. Your hair looks like it's in pretty good condition. So, that is very good. That's very good. But, we still need to put protection on your scalp and your face. Like, the neck area. It's exposed because bleach is it will sting if it gets on your skin and if there's no like protection to it. Okay, so I'm gonna put coconut oil in your hair. Is that okay? Okay. Thanks. This will pretty much prevent the sting. Also, this is bad practice, but I'm not gonna do a strand test or a patch test on your skin. I know it's bad practice, but we're running a little low on time, you know? So, oh gosh, it's kind of gross, isn't it? I've used it quite a lot for my hair. So what I'm gonna do is coconut oil has a really low melting point, so all I need to do is put it while I like dig in with my fingers. This should not be used for anything else other than hair because it's been used so many times. Luckily, it is antibacterial. Praise the Lord. So, I'm gonna do this now and spread it on your scalp and on your hair so that it doesn't get. It will help to protect it from the damage of the bleach because the bleach is, once again, it's no joke. And it will also protect your scalp, hopefully, because it's also quite irritating, the bleach. I mean, that's what helped my hair and scalp to get through all those multiple sessions of bleaching. Especially for Asian hair, virgin Asian hair. It's very, very difficult to bleach properly. That is. Already melting. Need a little bit more. These clams are way too big. I really hope in this weather it doesn't freeze on your hair because the melting point is really low, so like it solidifies really, really quickly as well. I actually once went after one of my bleachings with the coconut oil in my hair. It was actually hilarious because my hair, you could pretty much shape it in any direction, any style you wanted, because the oil essentially acted as a gel. It was an awesome experience, kind of awkward, you know. Relatively well. Let's do the Vaseline, that's right. We don't want the bleach to be getting on your face or the skin around your head. Vaseline / petroleum jelly, whatever you like to call it. And that was your forehead, and now we need to do it a little bit around the back of the ears a little bit. Just keep spreading it. And the other side. think that is sufficient. I'm gonna take these off because I have another pair awaiting my usage. So that was Vaseline. And this is coconut oil. Right here. Even the outside is a little bit oily. This away. Now I'm gonna, probably should have done this before. Now I'm gonna like put a protection around your neck and essentially the rest of your body. But we're on a budget here, so like it's gonna be used. You'll see what I'm gonna do. Proudly present to you our finest product of this video, a garbage bag. I have already cut a hole in it for your neck and your arms so you know you can like mess on your phone and stuff. Now I'm gonna just put this around. You're gonna wear it like a shirt, okay? Was this done with your consent? Dubiously so. Wrap this around you. Over here. Okay. Keep this in place. I'll put that in place right there so it won't slip and do anything funny. Okay, that looks good. Protection is done. Now what we're gonna do is I need to section your hair into essentially four parts. That, let me just really quickly brush through it, get rid of all the knots. I'm doing this after I put in the coconut oil, because coconut oil pretty much just smooths everything out, so that's very good. We will be primarily using plastic products because metals can get oxidized by the bleach, so we want to use plastic. I haven't applied the bleach yet, but that's what we'll be doing. Okay. Now let me section up your hair. They have a small metal thing in that, but I think it'll be fine. Very good. I've sectioned it up and I'll I'm gonna mix the bleach now. We wanna mix the bleach pretty much right before we use it. You know, because maximum potency. And I'm gonna go. So let me introduce everything to you. Okay. Right, so first of all, we have the mixing bowl, which we'll be using a lot. Put that right there. Now we have all our brushes. Is it bad that I still see a little bit of bleach from last time? That's probably not a good sign, but it should be okay. We'll survive this, hopefully. And there's also the developer, a shower cap, and the bleach itself. I'll be using L'Oreal Quick Blue. And just in case, I'll be putting on my gloves. It may look like a huge bottle, I mean a huge tub that is, but and you look inside and it's like this. It's not a lot. It looks like quite a lot from the outset. It really is not. That's the, what do they call it? The activating powder. Well, this is the bleach we'll be using today. I'll be using a rather weak developer. 20 volume, I prefer 30. 30 is very good. We'll be doing an on-scalp application. So one scoop of it. Yep. Pretty much you mix it until it... You can't see the bleach anymore. I know, we'll be okay. I know what I'm doing. I rinsed it with my own scalp. So you'll be perfectly fine. Don't worry. Yes, we'll check it in regular intervals. No heat. No external heat needed. It will take a while to, like, process. The processing is... Processing is a very long process, if that makes sense. Next up, you can see the bleach remnant still right there. I did not clean up very well, did I? This is 20 volume. I couldn't find the L'Oreal developer. Do they even have one? I'm not too sure. Again, let me just rant about how nothing ships here. Well, 20 volume. typically you would use 30. 40 is a bit much in some cases. 20 is very gentle, so I'll be using this. And it also comes with a tiny, like, a cap to put over it once you've finished applying the bleach. And you let it sit and process for however long you need to. And yeah, it's right there. Have you used box dyes in the past? I also have this. I don't know when I got it, but I do. But this was before I got the L'Oreal Quick Blue. This is. I guess it's okay if you have the recommended hair colors. And it's pretty easy, I suppose. But box dyes, meh. Now I'm gonna start mixing the solution, the bleach. So what we're gonna do. Scoop, one scoop of the bleach into this. Followed by that, we now put the developer in there, and basically what we do is mix it until everything blends into like this blue solution. Right. Gloves are super tight. Alright. It looks very blue, doesn't it? Now I'm gonna use the big brush. What is it? Looks bluer than I imagined it to be. need to put on my gloves again. So what I basically am going to do is start from the very ends of your hair and work my way up to the roots, because, well, hair, there's a lot of heat emitted from the roots, from your scalp, right? So that causes bleach to be activated and processed the rest of your hair. So we need to compensate for that. I tried two box features. One of it was a Japanese one, specifically. It was really good, actually, pull tea. And the second one was, Schwashkoff. One of their box bleaches. Was it L'Oreal? I cannot remember. Sorry. Terrible memory. I used them because they were the most accessible in the area. Super very good at working with layers. I kind of just end up going for it all over the place. You have colored a surprisingly large amount of your hair already. I think I made more than I expected. Like, I thought we would need more, but I don't think we do, surprisingly. Okay, let me just massage it a little bit in. All notion of layers and sectioning has been gone, but your ends are pretty much done. Now all I have to do is to probably fix up on the scalp areas. And since we still have so much bleach left over, I think I'll just keep saturating it and making sure that it doesn't dry out. Because that will really screw up how it's, you know, the bleach. It'll screw up the results, basically. Really, really thought that I would need more time than this. Okay. appears to be okay. I'm gonna put on a wig. Not a wig, what am I talking about? First of all, I need one free hand. Okay, now that both my hands are mobile, I'm gonna put this shower cap over your head. Ready? Okay. Now that it's on, I think. Okay, yeah, it's on. Properly, it will help to maintain the heat from your scalp and hopefully speed up the process a little bit. Meanwhile, we can both plug in our phones for a little while. I'll do regular check on your hair to make sure nothing goes wrong. So, don't worry. You can play on your phone in peace. Yeah. Okay. Judging by the look of that, it's not quite at the right level that we want, but I don't think we should leave it on for too long. It's already been more than enough time. So, okay. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna tip your head back. So firstly, close your eyes, and I'll tip your head back softly, and I will rinse the bleach out from your hair. I have my gloves ready. Tap is good, so just close your eyes. I'm gonna walk around you. And now I'm behind you. So I'm gonna help you to clean the bleach out of your hair. Is that okay? can bleach and a lot of drumming to get it to like the color you want. This is probably not what you had in mind when you got me to bleach your hair, and we'll probably need a second bleaching. Don't have a mirror hair right now, sorry. I suppose it's not quite what you wanted. Yeah, so the thing is about bleaching, it goes through several phases of hair color, because hair tends to be composed of red. So when we begin to lose some of that red, first it goes into orange before transitioning into yellow. I'm sure you will rock this opportunity to have neon orange hair for a couple of weeks. You know, it's okay, hair will grow back. We're gonna bleach it again to get it to the right, you know, the right color. Unless you like this, and it's your choice. I hope you're not mad at me for giving you such neon hair. I guess, well, I suppose it really puts you out of your comfort zone, right? Okay. Well, it's been quite a while. Let's get you changed out of these clothes and that garbage bag. You didn't wear new clothes to bleach your hair, right? Okay, good. Because this is an old t-shirt as well. Thank you, thank you. Thank you so much. I'll see you very soon. Actually, let's go grab some bubble tea, some boba, right after this.